A little confusion from a few Super Bowls past. You are from Detroit, right?
Born and raised.
All right, just getting that out of the way. So tell me about this director of Fandemonium promotion that you're working
with. It's a great promotion, and what we're doing is trying to find the next director, the next kind of leader of the fan department for the NFL. And you're down to the final two,
right.
Amy from San Diego and Ralph from Miami. And all we got to do is, there's two more days left for voting. And so what you do is you go to NFL.monster.com, you read up on both of the candidates, you vote, and the decisions are going to be made on Super Bowl Sunday on CBS. So it's a great opportunity for one fan to be immersed in football all year long next year.
So I understand with the 32 finalists, you were doing some boardroom interviews with Sterling Sharpe, right?
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
So what sort of things were you asking
the people? Well, you know, we were asking them how much knowledge of the NFL do they know, you know, what's some of the rules of the game. Just a lot of different things just to kind of test their full knowledge of football, not just players, but of the rules, of offense, of defenses, that type of thing, just to get a full idea of what they knew.
Sure. So getting away from that a little bit, just going into some Steelers stuff. Last month, you had talked about Bill Cowher. He's sort of like looking at the Jets, not Jets, the Giants job. He's coming back. You were saying he was kind of sitting out waiting for that to open up, and then Cowher shot back. You know, he hasn't talked to you. He said he hadn't talked to you in 2 years. So, I mean, are you still... Is that still sort of your stance?
I didn't base any of what I said on him on talking to him.
Okay.
I just base it on what I see. So that's what I see, and that's what I think it is.
Sure. And you had said back in December, the Steelers, you know, had struggled down the stretch. You said they had lost some spirit. So in addition to some motivational stuff, what sort of things do you think they need to do with the offseason to bounce back?
They just need to concentrate on running the football. I think they got to get back to running the ball. I think they've got a dynamic offense in terms of pass offense.
Right.
But they've got to be good at running the football. Until they are good at running football, they won't be able to close out games. And if you can't close out games, you can't win a championship.
Well, then what do you think about them keeping Bruce Arians on? Because he's obviously a guy who's really enamored with the passing game.
Well, I just think he needed to be, you know, brought to the side and just tell, hey, we got to tweak this offense. And I don't think it's a problem because he's done it 2 years ago. He was running the football a lot more than he did last year. We know he can do it. It's just a matter of him wanting to do it. I think coach has probably talked to him in such a way that he understands that there's a sense of urgency to run the football, and I believe that'll happen.
Right. So what's your feeling on most, I mean, it's not even really a trend it seems most teams are doing now, the running back by committee thing. That's kind of what you were doing the last few years of your career.
Well, you know what, I don't necessarily agree with it, and I don't believe in it. I think, you know, the last couple of years, I was kind of the short yardage guy, you know, but I believe in a feature guy. You got to give one guy an opportunity to go out and make the plays for you. I mean, if you try to two platoon guys, nobody ever gets into a flow, into a vibe, but I don't think it works. So I'm not a proponent of that split bags and that two platooning guys. I think you got to have one guy and you ride your horse.
So I would say Brandon Jacobs is probably like closest back to you in the NFL right now. Would you agree with that?
Well, I mean, in size, I think Michael Turner probably in the what he does based on what I did. Brandon Jacobs was a little taller, a lot taller. So our moves and the things that we did aren't quite that similar. But our size, the sheer size, is definitely similar.
Sure. So how did you deal with Super Bowl week in 06 when it was in your hometown?
You know, I just embraced it. I did an awful lot of interviews and a lot of things. But the one thing that I did was I took the pressure off of my young quarterback and my young running back. And so I wasn't starting in that game. So to put the pressure on me was irrelevant. So I was able to take some pressure away from the key guys, and I think it helped us win.
So how's been the change for you from moving to like the press side of it, covering players, as opposed to how are you when you're in the league and maybe you got
it's been different because obviously I've had to criticize some guys that I played maybe would not necessarily criticize, but because it's my job now, these are things that I have to do, and that's part of it.
So how do you see this year's Super Bowl playing out? You have a pick for us?
Yeah, I think the Saints are going to win it. I think it's going to be a close game, but I just think the Saints are going into this game like, hey, we've got a chip on our shoulder. Everything's been about Peyton down here. We've got something to prove, and we're going to go out and prove it.
Great. All right. Well, thanks a lot.
Hey.